Hello again, everybody. It's TJ, the Stereo Bargain File, and I am very, very, very pumped up today to finally bring you all an overview today, a quick overview of the Emotiva BASX Stack, or what I like to call Solid State Muscle on a Budget. That's right. I'm calling the Emotiva BASX Bigger Stack. I'll get into that in a minute. I am calling it Solid State Muscle on a Budget. And the top component you see right here in front of you, well, that's the PT100, which is the two-channel digital analog preamp and tuner. And the bottom component down here, that is the two-channel amplifier. And that amplifier is class AB, and it is rated at 150 watts at 8 ohms and 300 watts at 4 ohms and aroundish 225 watts at 6 ohms, somewhere around there. And to start off with, the PT100, the preamp tuner on top, sells for $299 US. And the bottom, the amplifier, the A300 BASX, it retails for, in the United States, $399 US. And that's a lot of Class AB power for the money, but that's the Emotiva's motto on their BASX line. So, real quick, I want to get a closer look for you all of the front and show you all the features and show you all the remote that comes with the Emotiva BASX PT100. Then I will turn it around to the back side and I will show you all the different digital connections, analog connections, and all right. Okay, I'm going to try to hold this camera the best I can for you all. As you can see, we're up close, and really the only button controls you have on the front of what I call the Emotiva stack. It's just basically a preamp-amp combo. But anyways, you know, you have your standby mode. You know, you can push this button here to turn it on or to put it in standby mode. Because on the back of the unit, you actually have your off and on toggle switch, which is really nice to have. And then we also have where you just have your inputs on the front. And down here, of course, we have our volume knob, and it's got, you know, it's got little different sections in it as you click around it. Don't make no loud noise. I really like the volume knob. Now, when I go to turn all this off, it will turn orange, and it does have a dimmer on it. I'm going to get to that here in just a second, and you can see we have a headphone input. And when I pop the hood, and yes, you know I got to pop the hood on something, I'll show you that Emotiva actually has its own little amplifier built inside just for the headphone, and it's okay. I'm not going to sit here and say it's really, really good. You know, the Emotiva PT100 digital analog preamplifier, you know, retails for $299 US, and in my opinion, that's a crazy good deal. And down here on the bottom, you'll see you just have two lights on the A300. And on the back of the unit, I will show you, you can turn those lights completely off. And again, you have a standby button at the bottom. I turn it off, you see it turns oranges. And here, I'll go ahead and do the top. Then I'll turn it back on to show you what it says when we turn it on. There we go. Pretty slick, really nice looking unit, built very strong. I think it's RU4 steel construction around the frame, but on the front face plate here, this is machined aluminum. And I really like these beefed up edges. You know, it's built like a tank. You know, if you're somebody that's moving a stereo system around a lot, or, you know, even in a club or even a bar scene, these can handle some abuse, I can tell you that. I've had the A300 actually for a year now, and I've had a lot of preamplifiers hooked up to it, so I know its sound character very well. But today I'm going to be talking about the sound character when it's being preamped by the PT100, the top unit. But I'm going to go over all that here in a minute. Okay, well, I'm going to turn it to the back. Hold on, hold on, before I forget. I'm really bad about forgetting the remote. Here's the little remote that comes with the PT100. It's nothing, you know, special or anything. It's very lightweight plastic, but you know what? It does its job. You know, I have a lot of vintage equipment that don't have remotes. So even having a remote is a big plus to me. But a lot of people in the forums wanted me to go over the remote just real quick with you all. I've been talking about it for a while with them. And a lot of people, what they do, this is not your menu button here in the middle. This is the mute button. Down here is your menu button, and it's very, very basic. So I'm going to push it, this bottom left button. That is my menu. I'll go over one. You see I have my bass. If I want to turn the bass up and down, I'll go over one more. Then you got to use your up and down keys. And then to get back out, go back one. Now you're to your bass. Now I can go up and down to go to my treble. But then to select it, I got to go over one. Then I got to go back and go up. It'll take you a day or two to get used to this. Then I'll go back over. Then I'll go up. And you see you have your balance, same thing. And then we'll go back down here and we'll click out. And I did not use the FM tuner dial on this. I'm sorry, so I will not be talking about that. So this time, instead of going under trims, you got to go up and got to go up and go to setup. Go to setup. Go over one. Here's your dimmer. Hit your dimmer again because you want to select it. Now you can go up and down. I don't know if y'all can tell that, but I keep it all the way down. Because it almost matches with the light on the bottom when I turn it almost all the way down. So let's exit out of here. Now, let's look at the back of the unit. Okay, so now we'll start with the preamp, the PT100, the top piece. And I'll go over the measurements here in a minute, the size dimensions of both the amp and the preamp, just here in a minute, because you can see the amp is just a little bit bigger. But anyways, if you look up here in the top left-hand corner, we have our grounding. This will be for a phono stage, and Motiva really hooked you up on this. You're getting moving coil and moving magnet. A lot of people online have said that for the money, it sounds really great using it, you know, for its preamp features. I haven't tested it, so I cannot comment on it. And there, of course, is your phono input, analog input. Then you have an analog input for CD and one for auxiliary, so you can hook two different analogs products up to this. Then next to it, we have our subwoofer outputs, and yes, they're both mono. There's no crossover tuning in. They're just coming out full range. If you wanted to tune in your powered subwoofer, you would have to have a crossover at the powered subwoofer and adjust the cutoff there if you were using it at 80 hertz or 60 hertz, kilohertz, whatever you all want to do. Next to it, yes, that is a FM antenna. And most people online, I did not check the FM tuner dial. No, I didn't. I'm sorry about that, but I'm not into FM anymore. But for people who are, well, that was a great little feature that Motiva added in there. Now we have our digital inputs. We have our coax digital input, our optical, our USB, and our PTM1. That is your Bluetooth monitor. It's really a receiver dongle that will plug like a flash drive right in the back. I did not get one because I already have the Motiva BTR1, which is an outboard Bluetooth receiver. But anyways, when you use these digital inputs on the PT100, its built-in DAC uses the DAC chip, Analog Devices 1955 DAC chip. And I'll try to show you that on camera when I pop the hood on both of them, but I want to go ahead and tell you, it's very hard to see. And I'll go over that sound quality of the built-in DAC on the PT100, but you all got to remember, this is a $299 US digital preamplifier with two analog inputs, tone controls. So now, let's go on down, and you can see we have a trigger out. Trigger out, you'll run a cable from here. We'll go down here real quick into the amplifier. That way, when you turn one into standby mode, the other one will go into standby mode. Because the only real way to turn them completely all the way off is back here. You do have nice toggle switches. This is a very, very great job, Motiva, for the total price of $700 in the U.S. Now, sometimes with the China tariffs, this can be all the way up to $760 brand new U.S. But you get a warranty and all that. And you can see we have two nice detachable, yes, I love detachable power cables. And that lets you, you know, if you're in the cables and upgrading them, that lets you take full advantage of this feature. But anyways, for a lot of people, it'll be just really convenient if you move your equipment around a lot. Okay, now down here on the bottom of the amplifier. Now, I've done reviewed this amplifier, but you all want to say this real quick. When I reviewed the BASX A300, I reviewed its total sound quality on two pre-amplifiers that I had at the time. And both of them were very warm amplifiers that had a lot of bass. So, I wished I would have had a neutral pre-amplifier and, you know, one that was a little bit brighter, you know, one on the cool side so I could do a comparison to both. Because the amplifier, the BASX A300, it does matter what preamplifier you use for its sound character. But it has its own sound, and I will go over that too. You can see here, this is where I can turn the front lights off and on. And here's your triggers, you know, one in and one out. If you were going to do bi-amping, you have your five-way binding post. Then you have your unbalanced inputs. And there is no gain controls. That is one caveat. Motiva has a circuitry board inside here that determines, and it sets that gain for you, so you don't have to mess with the gain at all. They have circuitry that already takes that care of that for you. And some people are like that, and some won't. Me, for instance, I like it. Here's the back of the amplifier telling you. 500 watts max, 230 volts, 50 hertz. I mean, yes. And that will be in other countries. In the U.S., we use the 115. Okay, now it's time to pop the hood. Okay, now I have popped the hood on the PT100 preamplifier on the right. And to the left, I have popped the hood on the Motiva BASX A300. So let's start out with the preamplifier first. So we're going to go down here in the preamplifier. You can see this is its power supply board right here. Then back here on the back, this is your analog. Shoot, I'm sorry, you all. I'm so sorry. Here's your analog inputs here, your digital over here. Let me get you closer. I just want to do this real quick. Right here, this chip, where'd it go? Yes. Okay, so sorry about that, you all. It's really bright. It's probably not going to come in for you all. But right here, right there, is your all's analog device. Right here is your all's analog device's 1955 DAC chip. And over here, you'll have your two different timing clocks for your digital input, which is 24-bit, 196 kilohertz. So this is more of your digital side. Then down here, you're getting into the analog. Then down here on the very end, this is your phono preamp. And as you can see, Motiva use Decon caps, which is pretty impressive for the price of this preamplifier. I want to be a little bit quicker now and do a little bit better job for y'all. Now, here's the power supply. This is where it's amping up that just a little bit to give that signal out. Here's your output stage, transistors, transformer, Decon again. That is cool that they use Decon caps. Now, over here, you can see it, and it's being jumped to from the main power supply. This goes to your headphone jack, so this is its own power supply. I thought that was really cool. Then here's your LED board for the front. Got nice, cool sinks. So, you know, it's laid out very, very simple. Great job, Motiva. Now let's take a look at the BASX A300. Okay, here we go with the inside of the BASX A300. At $399 US, this is a really good deal, you all. You can see the big, massive, nice, heavy-duty heat sink. Here's your output stage transistors. Here's your protection circuitry coming in. And here's the pie. That's right. That is a massive size toroidal transformer. Then over here, you can see we have our caps. They just say Motiva on it, and that's it. Here you all go. But they sure look like them Decon caps. I'll say that, Motiva. They look a lot like them, but they're 40,000 microfarads capacitors. Altogether, they're 10,000 each. So that gives you a total of 40,000. And here's the fans. And some of the people on the forums I read had some problems with the fans. Well, I got down to the bottom of the deal with the fans. What ended up happening is Motiva, about a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, they got in just a small batch of fans that, you know, wasn't working well. Well, a couple of those amplifiers ended up getting those fans in, but when it's still under warranty, send it back to Motiva. They will take care of you. They got awesome customer service. I've never had an issue. I bought mine at the end in December of 2018, and I have put this amp through it, you all. I've used it to help buy amp, pushed every speaker I've had with it. I've driven it hard. The fans have never came on. I never had a single problem with it. It has been very, very good. So I guess you could say I've had it for 15, 16 months, and I've been very impressed with it, especially for its price point. So now I'm going to talk about how the complete stack, the PT100, sounds with the A300. Then I'm going to talk about how the A300 sounds by itself. So hold on for 1 second. But first, before I give my subjective opinion of the sound character of the complete PT100 A300 BASX by Motiva, I want to give an applaud to Motiva's Vice President of Engineering, Ray Dennison, and his team of engineers for building such a powerful separate system at a very, very low cost of $700. That's truly amazing. It's price to performance. You get a lot of bang for the buck. And again, 150 watts at 8 ohms, 300 watts at 4 ohms, which that was rated at pretty high distortion beyond what us audiophiles like to accept. Anything over 0.05 THD, us audiophiles, we start shaking a little bit. But anyways, but some distortion's good when it comes to tubes. But anyways, I don't want to be talking about getting off subject. But now for my subjective opinion. Okay, now for my subjective opinion of the sound character of the PT100 preamplifier and the A300 two-channel power amplifier paired up together. Basically, it has this very clean, forward, cool sound to it. That's right, clean. Oh, somebody's knocking. Hold on. Sorry about that, you all. That was UPS. But anyways, I'll get back to where I was. I was talking about the overall sound signature. And to me, you know, it's just a cool, clean, forward-sounding combination. The bass, it's got good bass. It's got good control, good dynamics, because it has, you know, a lot of power. The mid-range, you know, the overall, this is going to be the easiest explanation. It does have the U, not a V sound signature where the bass is boosted up in the treble and there's no mid-range, because there is mid-range. So you got more of a U-shaped sound, because on some of the vocals, one of the caveats for me, on some of the male and female vocals, sometimes it can sound a little bit too forward. But it really depends on what kind of speakers that you're putting them on. You know, if you put them on a speaker with metal dome tweeters or a horn-loaded tweeter, you know, on recordings that aren't the best of recordings, that are just good or okay recordings, well, yeah, all day long. But anyways, the top end, you know, it is a little bit on the bright side of neutral. But that's not always a bad thing, because, you know, really on great recordings, it's not fatiguing at all. And right now I'm talking about the overall sound character when you use the digital input of the PT100 using the internal DAC. Now with a $299 US digital preamplifier that I also is has two analog inputs and a phono stage and a tuner. And you can plug up a Bluetooth dongle, but that's using the digital again. I'm going to get to the analog just here in a minute. You know, at $299, you're not going to get a built-in DAC that sounds like a $600 or $700 DAC. That's not going to happen. But for the money at $299, I do think the built-in DAC and everything that Emotiva gives you for $700, I think it's a great deal. And the instrument separation, you know, it's basically a level above if you're using an AVR, you know, audio video receiver to listen to music. This is more than likely going to be a step up from it. I have the Marantz NR1409, and it has direct mode 2-channel, and I can tell you the PT100 sounds a lot more musical, has better instrument separation. But I will even push it all the way up against, you know, it competes around $700 to $1,000 integrated amp. It will compete with it. But, you know, overall, that's the digital input sound character. But, you know, when I go to use the analog input, I use my own DAC or my digital transport. Well, of course, it starts to sound a lot better. You know, for somebody out there that's got a higher-end DAC that's a preamp also, but they have no tone controls, you have no analog inputs at all, and you have no phono input, no tuner, and you want some of those features with that DAC to be able to control, you know, the coloration of your room so you can use tone controls. Well, for $299, I think this would work out very good for those people, because when I use my DAC and, like I said, my digital transports, now the sound has changed. That U sound ain't as much, you know, doesn't sound as more like a U when you use the built-in DAC. When I use better outboard DACs with it, yes, it sounds better. But, you know, that's $299. That's what to expect from that. But anyways, I'm starting to ramble on too much. But anyways, you got great, you know, dynamics. And one thing this is going to have over most of your budget integrated amps and even your two-channel receivers, it's going to have a sense of scale. You're going to have a lot more power with this complete stack over them. Now, will it compete with a $1,000 integrated amp? Well, I've owned a lot of $1,000 integrated amps. And yes, quite frankly, it will. Now, will it beat all of them? No, because there is no best. But it will hold its own against a $1,000 integrated amp. That's one thing that was on my mind a lot. But anyways, when I use that analog, you know, input with my DACs, I got better instrument separation, wider sound stage. You know, it's just a really great deal for budget. But overall, in this complete stack, the real gem, the true gem, you all, is this amplifier on the bottom. You know, Emotiva was manufacturers of amplifiers before they done anything else at all. And this A300 on the bottom, BASX, I've had it, you know, almost a year and a half, 14, 15 months, put all kinds of abuse to it. It has been so solid. I put a warm sounding preamp on it. It sounds warm. I put a bright sounding preamp on it. It sounds bright. I put a neutral sounding preamp on this BASX A300 at the bottom. It sounds almost neutral. Now, does that mean it sounds neutral and it's very well balanced? No, not at all. Still, you know, the mid-range is down. The bass is boosted up a little bit. You know, the top end's boosted up just a little bit, you know, more. So, you know, you get that cool, clean, forward sound. And it has that also when you use the analog inputs. But this is my take overall for $700. I think it's a great deal. I'm running out of time. And I know you all want a comparison. And I am going to compare the Emotiva BASX PT100 A300. I am going to compare it against the Iota VX stack. Now realize the Iota VX stack is $200 new. Then I'm going to compare it against what was the gatekeeper for so long, because this has an awesome preamplifier in it. And this is the Pioneer Elite SXN30. It was $800 US new. So I'm just going to make a video of comparing all three of them. So you got $700, $800, $900 when the bottom piece here, the SA3, when it's on sale for $499. Sometimes the SA3, normally the MSRP, I think it's $559 or maybe $549. But I'm going to compare all three of them in one video for you all. But yeah, if you like that kind of sound, you know, if you like that Ford kind of sound, you know, that cool sound, very clean sounding, you know, for the money, audio equipment nowadays is just getting very good. You get a big bang for the buck. And this truly is, for $700, this is some solid state muscle. And you're going to drive just about any speaker that you want to. So until next time, this is TJ, Stereo Bargain Foul.